السلام عليكم dear student, I'm Dr. أسماء محمد. I'm gonna to explain to you this lecture today entitled TCA cycle. First of all, TCA cycle is the abbreviation of tricarboxylic acid cycle. Tri which means three, carboxylic which means COOH group. This is the most common name of this the cycle is the TCA cycle. We have two molecules inside the TCA cycle which have the tricarboxylic group or three carboxy group. These molecules are citrate and isocitrate. We will know the difference between them later on. Tricarboxylic acid cycle also called Krebs cycle. After the Sir Hans Krebs, who first explained this cycle, and also called citric acid cycle, cause the product of first reaction is the citric acid. Citric acid cycle or tricarboxylic acid cycle play several roles in the TCA cycle is the pathway for oxidation of many molecules inside our body. It is the common pathway for oxidation of acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA is produced from amino acid oxidation, glucose oxidation, produced from acetate and fatty acid oxidation and ketone body oxidation. All these molecules give us acetyl-CoA which enter the TCA cycle. Acetyl-CoA is the substrate for TCA cycle, and TCA cycle account for two-thirds of the ATP generation from the foul oxidation. TCA cycle is the final catabolic pathway of carbohydrates, amino acids, and fatty acids. Acetyl-CoA is oxidized inside the TCA cycle and give us two molecules of CO2 or carbon dioxide and energy in the form of NADH plus proton, FADH2 and GTP. So it is the central for energy generation inside our So Krebs cycle starts by acetyl-CoA which bind to oxaloacetate. Acetyl-CoA is 2 carbon and oxaloacetate is 4 carbon. They come together and give by enzyme called citrate thenase enzyme to give us a citrate. Citrate is 6 carbon. TCA cycle or Krebs cycle during the cycle, acetyl-CoA is oxidized to 2 molecules of carbon dioxide to give us the oxaloacetate again, which is 4 carbon. We will take every step in details later on. What are the reactant of TCA cycle? The reactant of TCA cycle acetyl-CoA, which is 2 carbon, carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, and oxaloacetate, which is 4 carbon, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon, bind together in presence of water to give us the citric acid, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon. This citric acid has tricarboxylic group, 3 carboxy group. يبقى الأسيتايل كو اي 2 كاربونز مسك مع الأوكزالو أسيتيت اللي هو 4 كاربونز واداني في الآخر الستريت اللي هو 6 أو 6 كاربون. لازم نبقى عارفين إن الستريك ده فيه 3 كاربوكسي جروب. إيه البرودكت بتاعتنا؟ كان كاربون. The final products of TCA cycle are carbon dioxide and water. 3 molecules of NADH plus proton, 1 molecule of FADH2, and 1 molecule of GTP. So the final product of TCA cycle are carbon, two molecules of carbon dioxide, pair one molecule of acetyl CoA, water, and three molecules of NAD H plus proton, one molecule of FAD H2, and one GTB. All this product of one acetyl CoA molecule. Enter the TCA. Where the TCA cycle occur? It occur inside the mitochondria. Cause the TCA cycle is aerobic pathway and oxygen is required as the final electron acceptor in the electron transport chain. Why TCA cycle is aerobic pathway? Cause the NADH and FADH2 produced by TCA cycle donate their electrons to the oxygen via the electron transport chain, which occur also inside the mitochondria with generation of ATP. This mechanism is called oxidative phosphorylation, production of ATP through the electron transport chain is called oxidative phosphorylation. As TCA cycle produce NAD and FADH2, we have to regenerate again NAD plus proton and FAD without the H and H2. So they have to donate these electrons to the oxygen with subsequent generation of new NAD plus proton and FAD and can enter another TCA cycle. These two occur, we have to have electron transport chain which accept this proton and give it to oxygen with generation of molecules of water and ATP. عشان كده TCA cycle عشان تحصل لازم تحصل في باثوي في ميديا ايروبيك. يعني ايه ايروبيك؟ يعني عندي اكسجين موجود. الاكسجين ده وظيفته ايه؟ ياخد الاتشات اللي موجوده على النات H بلس بروتون والفاد H2، ياخدها ويتحد معاها ويديني مولكيولز اوف ووتر ويطلع لي الاي تي بي. الاي تي بي اللي بيطلع بالباثوي ده اسمه ايه؟ اوكسيداتيف فوسفوريليشن. اوكي كده؟ لان في اي تي بي بيطلع دايركت من ذا reaction، دي هناخدها بعد شوية اسمها ايه. Overall the reaction of TCA. So let's start to explain steps of the TCA cycle. First reaction is start by reactant or acetyl CoA and oxaloacetate by enzyme called citrate synthase enzyme and one molecule of water enter and the coenzyme A is exit from the reaction. They give us the product which is the citrate. Acetyl CoA is two carbon molecules which bind to coenzyme A. This coenzyme A is go out from the reaction combined by oxaloacetate. Oxaloacetate as we see here is 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon. We have to know that oxaloacetate is alpha keto acid. What mean by alpha keto acid? Any acid have carboxy and any acid has an acidic group. This here we have a carboxy group which is acidic group. So carbon after the acidic group is called alpha beta gamma. As we see in oxaloacetate, the alpha carbon is bind to the keto group by C double bond O. So this group is called the keto group. Keto group is attached to the beta carbon of this acid, though, so the oxaloacetate is alpha keto acid. This is important later on. We will explain it later. Okay? We have to know that oxaloacetate is alpha keto acid. Alpha keto mean the alpha carbon is attached to the ketone group which is C double bond O. Okay كده acetyl CoA two carbon bind to oxaloacetate give us a citrate. Citrate is six carbon molecule. We have to know that the citrate is tricarboxylic acid. It means it has three carboxy group. So the citrate synthase act on acetyl CoA and oxaloacetate to give us the citrate. Since the citrate synthase, we know to synthesize an enzyme, we have two options: synthase or sensitase. Since the citrate is synthase, not sensitase, so we don't need a source of ATP. يبقى هنا الأسيتيل كو اي اللي هو 2 كربونز كربونتين هيمسك في الأوكسالو أسيتيت اللي هما 4 كربونات والإنزيم اسمه سيتريت سينسيز هيديني السيتريت. السيتريت هنا 6 كربون 6 كربونات والرياكشن ده irreversible reaction. This reaction go in one direction so it is irreversible reaction. لازم بس كلنا نبقى عارفين ان هنا في الاستيل كو اي 2 كربون اهو والاكسيل اسيت 4 كربونات. لازم نبقى عارفين ده اسمه الفا كيتو اسيد. ليه اتسمى الفا كيتو اسيد؟ لان الكربون احنا اي اسيد بيبقى عنده اسيد جروب. هنا في الاكسيل اسيتات هو السي او او اتش او الكربوكسي جروب. تمام كده. الكربونز اول كربون بعد الاسيد بتبقى الفا. الالفا دي ماسك فيها اي سي دبل بوند او يبقى دي الفا كيتو اسيد وبالتالي اسمه الفا كيتو اسيد. يبقى ليه؟ لان في كيتون جروب ماسكه في الالفا كربون بتاعته. المعلومه دي مهمه هنقولها في المحاضره الجايه ان شاء الله ليه المعلومه دي مهمه. تمام كده. واخر حاجه الستريت لازم نبقى عارفين ان هو فيه 3 كربوكسي جروب. يبقى in any reaction we have to know the reactant molecule and the name of the enzyme and the product name. And this reaction is reversible or irreversible. Reversible means go in one direction. Irreversible means the reaction can go in the both direction. In citrate synthase, citrate synthase is irreversible reaction go in one direction give us the citrate. The second step is performed by a kinase enzyme which act on citrate as a substrate and giving the product isocitrate. The difference between citrate and isocitrate is the location of this OH group. You have to know that akinetase is reversible enzyme and which act on citrate to give isocitrate. As we see here the location of OH group in this carbon while in citrate, while in isocitrate the location of OH group is substituted in this carbon. Okay. يبقى الاكينيتيز انزيم ده بيشتغل على السيتريت عشان يحوله لايزوسيتريت. هو جاست بيغير مكان الاو اتش جروب من الكربون دي للكربون اللي تحتيه بس كده. The third step is performed by enzyme called isocitrate dehydrogenase enzyme. The isocitrate dehydrogenase enzyme act on isocitrate to give the alpha ketoglutarate product. Here the reactant is isocitrate and the product is, as we can see, the isocitrate is 6 carbon while the alpha ketoglutarate is 5 carbon. This means that the isocitrate dehydrogenase enzyme is make oxidation for decarboxylation reaction. What mean by oxidation? Loss of proton as NAD plus proton is converted to NAD H plus proton. This called oxidation. Oxidation is loss of electron or loss of proton. Okay, and decarboxylation is one carbon atom from the isocitrate is released in the form of CO2. This is called decarboxylation reaction. And decarboxylation reaction need manganese as a cofactor. This reaction, which is oxidative decarboxylation reaction, is irreversible reaction go in one direction. As we see here, the 2H atom is carried on NAD plus to give us the NAD H plus proton. And the carboxy group here is released as carbon dioxide. So the product is alpha keto glutarate or alpha keto glutaric acid. Alpha keto acid, as we said before, in carbon, alpha carbon next to the carboxy end of this acid, there is ketone or double bond O group attached to the alpha carbon, so it is alpha keto acid or alpha keto glutarate enzyme. As we know, the TCA cycle is to oxidation of the acetyl CoA. Acetyl CoA is formed of two carbon. So we have to perform two decarboxylation reactions. The first decarboxylation reaction is isocitrate dehydrogenase enzyme. In this reaction, we make oxidation of the isocitrate to give alpha keto glutarate. One molecule of CO2 is released and one molecule of NAD plus proton is converted to NAD H plus proton. يبقى تالت step هي الايزوستريت ديهيدروجينيز انزيم. احنا قلنا الاستايل كو اي ده بيتكون من 2 كربون واحنا حطيناه على اوكسال اسيتيت وادينا سيتريت. احنا عايزين نعمل اوكسيديشن الاستايل كو اللي موجود جوه السيتريت، فاحنا هنعمل ديكربوكسيليشن رياكشن مرتين او اوكسيديتيف ديكربوكسيليشن رياكشن مرتين. اول واحد فيهم هو الايزوسيتريت ديهيدروجينيز. طيب الايزوسيتريت ديهيدروجينيز بيعمل حاجتين، اوكسيديشن وديكربوكسيليشن. اوكسيديشن يعني ريموفال اوف 2H، نحطهم على الناد بلس بروتون يتحول الى ناد H بلس بروتون ونشيل ال CO2. دي اسمها ايه؟ دي كاربوكسيليشن. طب الرياكشن ده ريفرسيبل ولا ايرريفرسيبل؟ بيمشي في الاتجاهين ولا اتجاه واحد؟ لا بيمشي في اتجاه واحد. اللي بيشتغل على الايزوسيتريت عشان يحوله لالفا كيتو جلوتاريت. طيب الايزوسيتريت ديهيدروجينيز انزايم از ان اكزامبل اوف اوكسيداتيف decarboxylation reaction. Oxidative removal of protons and decarboxylation is removal of CO2 or removal of carbon dioxide. This enzyme don't contain CoASH or enzyme CoA. The fourth step is alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase enzyme, in which alpha keto glutarate is converted to the succinyl CoA. This enzyme is also oxidative decarboxylation reaction. As we see here, the removal of CO2, which so this enzyme is decarboxylation reaction, and NAD is transformed into NAD H plus proton. So this enzyme also is oxidative decarboxylation reaction. Here in this enzyme, the CoA in the reactant and the product is succinyl CoA. As we see, the carbon dioxide is removed, so this
reaction is decarboxylation.
So the alpha ketodehydrogenase enzyme is an example of oxidative decarboxylation oxidative, as we see here, the loss of protons, and decarboxylation, the removal of CO2. We have to know which steps in the TCA cycle. We produce NADH plus proton. This reaction is the second one to produce NADH plus proton, and the second one to release CO2. The first one was the isocitrate dehydrogenase enzyme. يبقى رابع حاجة هو الألفا كيتو جلوتاريد ديهيدروجينيز إنزيم، ده كان بيشتغل على الألفا كيتو جلوتاريد عشان يتحول إلى ساكسينايل كو إي. الألفا كيتو جلوتاريد ده كام كربوناية؟ 5 كربونات، تحول إلى ساكسينايل كو إي 4 كربونات، معناه إن أنا في كربوناية خرجت in the form of CO2. طب الرياكشن ده ريفرسيبل ولا irreversible؟ طبعا هو irreversible، بيمشي في اتجاه واحد. يبقى lasting about alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase is irreversible reaction if this enzyme is go in one direction which act on alpha keto glutarate which is 5 carbons to transform it into succinyl CoA which is 4 carbons atom. Alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase enzyme is oxidative decarboxylation reaction typical as BDH complex or pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. The pyruvate dehydrogenase complex is complex of 3 enzymes bonded together and 5 coenzymes. The enzymes are alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase enzyme, dihydrolipoyl transacetylase enzyme, and dihydrolipoyl dehydrogenase enzyme. The coenzymes, thymine pyrophosphate, coenzyme E, or CoASH, lipoic acid, the FAD, and NAD. Okay? It is very important to know the 3 enzymes and 5 coenzymes of alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase enzyme, and also they are the same as pyruvate dehydrogenase enzyme complex, which is formed of 3 enzymes and 5 coenzymes. The 3 enzymes of alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase enzyme are alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase enzyme, dihydrolipoyl transacetylase enzyme, and dihydrolipoyl dehydrogenase enzyme. The 5 coenzymes are thymine pyrophosphate, coenzyme A, or CoASH, or QuASH, lipoic acid, FAD, and the NAD. We have to know this reaction is inhibited by arginate. Any enzyme contain lipoic acid, arginate bind to the lipoic and inhibit this reaction. But arginate make inhibition to alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase. This is the 5th step is the succinate thiokinase or succinyl CoA sensitase enzyme act on succinyl CoA to convert it to the succinate. As the succinyl CoA is formed in the last step, which is 4 carbon, I want to convert this succinyl CoA to oxaloacetate, which is also 4 carbon. First thing is removal of S-CoA or this quash. This reaction is to remove this S-CoA. One molecule of water enter and CoASH is removed to give the succinate. Here in the S-CoA, binding to succinyl, there is high energy bond. This high energy bond is used to convert the GDB into GTB. As we see here, the succinyl CoA bind to CoA and GDB 1-phosphate to give the succinate or succinic acid and CoASH plus GTB. يبقى احنا خمسة step ان احنا نحول السكسينيت ساكسينيل سوري كو اي الى ساكسينيت. ليه احنا بنعمل كده؟ لان الساكسينيل كو اي ده اربع كربونات، عايز ارجع تاني احوله للاوكسالو اسيتات عشان ياخد 1 مولكيول تاني فاستايل كو اي واعمل له اوكسيديشن. طب الساكسينيل كو اي ده زياده حته كو اي على الاربع كربونات، فالهدف الستيب دي ان انا اشيل الكو اي اس اتش. فالساكسينيل كو اي بالانزيم اللي هو ساكسينيت سايو كاينيز، ناخد بالنا ان الرياكشن ده ريفرسبل، بيمشي في الاتجاهين عشان يديني الساكسينيت. بس الساكسينيل كو اي ماسك هنا في الاس كو اي بهاي انرجي بوند. الهاي انرجي بوند دي بنستغلها ان احنا ناخد جي دي بي نحوله الى جي تي بي. يبقى the last thing about the succinyl CoA is it is reversible. Reaction can go in both directions. And production of GTB in this reaction. Is it oxidative phosphorylation or something else? It is succinate cyclokinase is a substrate level phosphorylation reaction in which formation of high energy phosphate bond without the use of oxygen or electron transport chain. It's not an oxidative phosphorylation reaction. The energy produced in the GTB is equivalent to that of the ATB. يبقى الساكسينيت سايكلينيز ده بيحصل فيه حاجة اسمها substrate level phosphorylation. substrate level phosphorylation يعني direct بيطلع لي ATP من الرياكشن، انا مش محتاج ان انا اروح للأكسجين يكون موجود ولا محتاج اروح electron transport chain، وبالتالي ده مش oxidative phosphorylation reaction. والانرجي اللي بتطلع لي من الGTP هي equal او مكافأة للي بتطلع لي من الATP. Here, the succinate, which is formed from the last step, we have to convert it into oxaloacetate. What is the difference between succinate and the oxaloacetate is carbon number 2. Here, the carbon is attached to 2 molecules of hydrogen, while in oxaloacetate, the carbon is attached to ketone group or C double bond O. What can I do to convert this CH2 into C double bond O? Just removal of 2 hydrogen atom by dehydrogenase enzyme. So here I have CH double bond CH, and then add water. So I have here COH and CH. Then removal of 2 hydrogen atom from here and here, so I get the oxaloacetate. So the next 3 steps is to convert the succinate into the oxaloacetate. Here I have carbon number 2 has 2 H atom attached to it, and in oxaloacetate the carbon number 2 is attached to the oxygen is alpha carbon or alpha keto acid. So what I have to replace these 2 hydrogen atom by ketone group, I have to remove these 2 hydrogen atom by dehydrogenase, then put a molecule of water. So this carbon atom attached to H and OH, and this carbon H and OH. This then removal of 2 H's at carbon number 2 or alpha carbon to be converted into alpha keto acid. يبقى احنا الستبس الثلاثة الباقيين ان انا عايز احول السكسينيت للاوكسالو اسيتات. الفكره هو الفرق ما بين السكسينيت والاوكسالو اسيتات ان الالفا كربون دي هنا فيه 2H وهنا فيه C دبل بوند O. الحل ان انا اشيل القشتين احط ميه بقت H O H و H، اشيل قشتين من نفس الكربونايه هيبقى C دبل بوند O بس. تمام كده. The sixth one is the succinate dehydrogenase enzyme. The succinate dehydrogenase enzyme act on succinate to give the fumarate. The succinate take two hydrogen atoms from the succinate and put this hydrogen on fat to convert it into fat H2. For the first time, we find the fat as hydrogen carrier and fumarate is the product. Okay, this reaction is reversible reaction and can go in both direction. The succinate dehydrogenase act on succinate removal of two hydrogen atom and put them on fat to give that fat H2 and the product is the fumarate. يبقى سادس reaction هو succinate بتحول لفيوماريت والاتشات اللي بنشيلها من الفات بتتحط على سوري من السكسينيت بتتحط على الفات عشان تتحول الى فاد H2. اول مره بلاقي الفات يبقى ساعتها البرودكت هنسميه الفيوماريت. اوكي كده. سكسينيت دي هيدروجينيز انزيم. Here the fat is cofactor for the oxidation reaction, which is very important. Competitively inhibited by malonate, and this enzyme is part of the inner mitochondrial membrane. The succinate dehydrogenase enzyme is competitively inhibited by the malonate, with which inhibit this reaction. Fumarase, the next one, fumarase act on fumarate to be converted into malate. This reaction is reversible, can go in both direction. Fumarase add water to convert the fumarate into the malate. In fumarate, we have here double bond and the fumarase enzyme break this bond. So in carbon number 2 is attached to H and OH and carbon number 3 is attached into 2H molecule. And the final reaction is the malate dehydrogenase enzyme. Malate dehydrogenase enzyme act on malate to remove 2H atom, which convert NAD into NADH plus proton and give us the oxaloacetate. The malate here contain H and OH, remove this H on NAD to be converted into oxaloacetate, which is alpha keto acid. يبقى الماليت دي هيدروجينيز اخر ستيب كان بتشتغل على الماليت تحول الى oxaloacetate. وطبعا الرياكشن ده كان باي دايركشنال بيمشي في الاتجاهين، كان بيحول الماليت into الاوكسالواسيتيت بيشيل الاتشات على الناد عشان يتحول الى ناد H بلس بروتون. اوكي كده. يكون عندي هنا الكيتون جروب. ماليت دي هيدروجينيز انزيم از ريفرسبل كان جو ان بوث دايركشن. هير ذا ستيبس اوف تي سي اي سايكل. وي ستارت باي اوكسالواسيتيت ويتش از 4 كربون بايند تو اسيتايل كولو اي ويتش از 2 carbon atom. 2 by citrate synthase enzyme in presence of water to give us the citrate. Citrate which is 6 carbon. This citrate is converted into isocitrate by aconitase enzyme. Then we start to make the oxidation to the acetyl-CoA molecule which is 2 carbon. So by isocitrate dehydrogenase enzyme give us the first CO2 or carboxy CO2 molecule, carbon dioxide molecule, and NAD
H plus proton to give us 5 carbon atom molecule, which is alpha keto glutarate, the next oxidative decarboxylation reaction by alpha keto glutarate enzyme complex which is oxidative remove of H and decarboxylation removal of the other CO2 from the acetyl CoA to give us the succinyl CoA, which is 4 carbon atom molecule. Then the reaction is just to confirm the other reaction is to convert the succinyl CoA to the oxaloacetate. First is removal of CoA by succinate thiokinase, which produce GTP, which is substrate level phosphorylation. I use this high energy bond to make GTP, and the product is succinyl CoA. Succinyl CoA by succinyl CoA dehydrogenase give us the fumarate with production of FADH2, and fumarate by fumarase enzyme, which put water, give us the malate. By malate dehydrogenase, we return back to the oxaloacetate. We have to know which reaction produced NADH plus proton, these three reactions, and which reaction produce FADH2, which reaction produce substrate level phosphorylation. So the steps for production of NADH plus proton and FADH2. These NADH and FADH2 go to electron transport chain to give us ATP through the electron transport chain. So the TCA cycle is aerobic pathway, as TCA as electron transport chain to work has need to presence of oxygen to. So let's go to the energy yield from the TCA cycle, which is very important. The first is the one molecule of GTP produced as the substrate level phosphorylation at the succinyl CoA synthase enzyme, which is equivalent to 1 ATP. The second is FADH2, which is produced at succinate dehydrogenase enzyme. This FADH2 give us the ATP through the electron transport chain, and FADH2 is converted back to the FAD. Each one molecule of FAD give us 2 ATP, and NADH plus proton, which is produced at 3 reaction. First is isocitrate dehydrogenase enzyme. Second is alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase enzyme, and last is malate dehydrogenase enzyme. Each one of NADH plus proton give us 3 ATP through the electron transport chain. Here the NADH and the FADH2 give us the substrate level phosphorylation, ATP at the level of substrate level phosphorylation. To summarize, in TCA cycle, we start by acetyl CoA, but acetyl CoA is formed of 2 carbons. So, one acetyl CoA is oxidized, relieve 2 molecule of CO2 and 3 molecule of NADH plus proton, and 1 FADH2 and 1 GTP. So TCA cycle فيها الأسيتيل كو اي اللي بيتكون من كربونتين بيطلع لي 2 مولكيول اوف كربون دايوكسيد و 3 مولكيول اوف NADH، 1 FADH2 و 1 GTP. the energy yield from the TCA cycle. Each NAD give us 3 ATP and each FAD give us 2 ATP in the electron transport chain. And an extra one is produced of ATP produced by substrate level phosphorylation at the succinate cyokinase enzyme. The total energy yield per one molecule of acetyl CoA is 12 ATP. This calculation is very 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 important. يبقى كل مولكيول of acetyl CoA بيطلع لي كام؟ بيطلع لي 12 ATP. ازاي؟ 3 مولكيولز من الناد بيطلع لي 3 ATP، 1 مولكيول من الفات بيطلع لي 2، 1 من ال substrate level phosphorylation. So the energy yield of the complete oxidation of one molecule of glucose according the condition. If this under aerobic condition, this give me 36 to 38 ATP. If under anaerobic condition, this give me only 2 ATP. Under aerobic condition, one molecule of glucose through the glycolysis give me 6 to 8 ATP according to the shuttle I used in glycolysis, and through the BDH complex it gave me 6 ATP, as each molecule of glycolysis give us one pyruvate by pyruvate dehydrogenase complex to give acetyl CoA. I have two molecules of pyruvate. These two molecules of pyruvate converted to two molecules of acetyl CoA, so produce two molecules of NADH plus proton and give us six molecule of ATP. In the TCA cycle, in each TCA cycle, we produce three NAD, one FAD and FADH2 and one ATP. Three NAD times three, as one NADH plus proton give us 3 ATP, and 1 FAD times 2, as each FAD H2 give us 2 ATP and 1 ATP. This give us 12 ATP per 1 acetyl CoA molecule each. Since each molecule of glycolysis give us 2 pyruvate and 2 pyruvate give us 2 acetyl CoA, so 2 acetyl CoA give us 24 ATP in the TCA cycle. So the total energy produced from one molecule of glycolysis, 6 plus 6, sorry, 8 plus 6 plus 24 equal to 38 or 36 ATP. We have to remember that vitamin B complex play vital role in the cycle and act as a coenzyme in many reactions. The thiamine pyrophosphate or thiamine P1, which is vitamin B1, give us the thiamine pyrophosphate. Riboflavin, which is P2, give us the fat, which is cofactor for the enzyme succinate dehydrogenase. Guanosine, which is vitamin B3, is give us the NAD, which is cofactor for the three reaction of two hydrogenases, the succinate D, sorry, the isocitrate dehydrogenase and the alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, and finally the malate dehydrogenase. The pantothenic acid is a coenzyme A or CoASH enter in the reaction of succinate cyokinase, and the a first step with each citrate synthase, and they are the component of BDH complex. BDH complex like the alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. Let's talk about the regulation of TCA cycle first, the short-term regulation. Regulation is short-term course, which is substrate availability, and fine regulation, which is allosteric control.
First, the coarse regulation or the substrate availability of the TCA cycle as the main function of the TCA cycle is an energy production. And these two occur is depend mainly on presence of active electron transport chain. So to TCA cycle to work, we have first to ensure that that electron transported chain is active and working, and there is availability of oxygen and so on. The coarse regulation, availability of oxygen, which is important for for electron transported chain, so give us the aerobic condition, and also the acetyl CoA and oxaloacetate, which is the substrate for the TCA cycle. To start the TCA cycle, we have to start by the substrate. What is our substrate? Is acetyl CoA and oxaloacetate. And also low energy state is a high ADP and high NADH net plus proton. The rate of utilization of ATP determines both the rate of respiration and the activity of the TCA cycle. فعشان TCA cycle تشتغل في حاجة كورس يعني حاجة أساسية عشان TCA cycle تشتغل إن أنا إحنا قلنا TCA cycle دي aerobic فلازم يكون عندي oxygen. طب إيه substrate بتاع TCA cycle لازم تكون موجودة؟ أنا أول step كنت بحط acetyl CoA plus oxaloacetate. طب وأنا ماشي في النص محتاج ان انا يكون عندي نات بلس بروتون كتير عشان احولها لنات اتش بلس اتش، والاي دي بي يكون كتير عشان انا بعملها اصلا عشان اطلع اي تي بي لان الاي دي بي اللي عندي قليل. So the amount بقى of ATP اللي عندنا هي اللي بتحدد انا هشتغل تي سي اي سايكل ولا لا. لو انا عندي اي تي بي كتير يبقى ده هيعمل لي انهبيشن للتي سي اي سايكل، لو انا عندي اي دي بي كتير بدا هيعمل استيميليشن لل TCA cycle. The fine second is the fine regulation or the allosteric regulation. The key regulatory enzymes for the allosteric regulation is the citrate synthase, the isocitrate dehydrogenase and the alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, which are the irreversible enzymes present in the TCA cycle. The irreversible enzymes are the key regulatory. First is citrate synthase, second isocitrate dehydrogenase, and third the alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. So what about the rate of TCA cycle and the muscle contraction and the utilization of ATP? When there is muscle contraction, there is an increase in the calcium inside the muscle cell. This calcium stimulates the citrate synthase and isocitrate dehydrogenase and the alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase enzymes all are activated. The fine regulation, the two dehydrogenases, which is isocitrate dehydrogenase and alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, all are activated by low energy state, high ADP over ATP, and high NAD over NADH. هي TCA cycle بيطلع لي ATP وبيطلع لي NADH كتير. فلما يكون عندي ADP كتير وناد كتير، دول بيعملوا لي stimulation للديهايدروجينيزس عشان يستيموليت TCA cycle. طب وthen did I mention any role of hormonal regulation of TCA cycle? No. Why? Because TCA cycle is very important for energy production and it have to work during fasting and during well-fed state. So no hormonal regulation in the TCA cycle, just coarse by substrate availability and fine regulation by calcium and low energy state. Okay؟ يبقى TCA cycle دي شغالة during well fed ولا during fasting؟ لازم تكون شغالة during الاثنين لأن جسمي
محتاج ان هي بتطلع لي تلتين الطاقه اللي بتطلع من الانرجي برودكشن في الجسم بتاعي. فهي شغاله during well fed وشغاله during الفاستنج. اللي بيعمل لها regulation just coarse regulation by substrate availability او fine regulation by calcium او low energy. Also citrate sensing enzyme is allosterically inhibited by ATP and citrate. Since ATP we have already high energy inside the cell, so which this inhibit the TCA cycle. Also citrate inhibit the TCA cycle and long chain fatty acid inhibit the citrate sensing enzyme. So citrate sensing enzyme is allosterically inhibited by ATP, citrate and long chain acyl-CoA or long chain fatty acids. Thank you.